God, I've missed you so much. Ain't a day went by. Let's give him about a little hug. Man, been a long time. 10 years.
Yeah.
10 years.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's fine. It's fine.
12-year-old Kalib Swafford just saw his biological father for the first time in a decade.
Just want you to know I've changed for the better. I've done a 360 in my life.
Yeah.
He knows more than any child should ever have to about the grip of heroin. It ripped his dad away from him.
You were going through so much when you was that age, man. I didn't have no means to get you to where you guys needed to be.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't.
Yeah, I understand.
So I let you guys just stay where you was. I knew you were well took care of.
Mm-hmm. Come on, just throw it.
Is it a crisis in this community?
Oh, I think so. The addiction to it and the hold that it has on people makes it really hard to get off of it.
But the kindness of strangers has saved Kalib. He's being raised by Cindy and Jesse Swafford, who took him and his brother in as foster children a decade ago, and then adopted them both.
It's a lot to cope with Kalib at 12 years old.
It's just been a lot better than I would have done with my other parents.
The most recent data show 50% of the children in Ohio's foster care system are there because of their parents' drug use, and more than half of those are because of an opioid addiction. Of the 15 foster children Cindy and Jesse have taken in, 13 are because of their parents' drug addiction.
I'm confident that if we opened another bed in our home, it would be filled with another baby with an opiate issue.
It's a sad reality.
It is. It's hard to hold a baby as they're withdrawing from heroin.
I hate to say it this way, but we kind of clean up a little bit of the mess. So, I mean, we need more people to help clean up the messes with us.
Kalib decided that even after so many years, he wanted to see his birth father, James, who says he's been clean from heroin for the past 18 months.
It's his choice if he wants to go back on them, but I feel like I can help in some way to motivate him to not use it again.
What do you think when you hear Kalib say that at 12 years old, he wants to be part of what helps his dad stay off of heroin?
I mean, it's scary because that's a big responsibility for a 12-year-old. And I also have a different understanding of the pull to heroin for these moms and dads. And I'm sure there's a part of him that really does want to stay clean for him. There's also a part of me that knows that it doesn't always work that way.
James says he was addicted to heroin for more than a decade. It cost him his family, his job, and even his home. But today, sober, he gets to see his son for the first time in 10 years.
How you feeling?
Emotional. Nervous. Been a long time.
Of course you've thought about all that the heroin took away from you.
Yeah. It took my whole life from me.
All your children?
All of them. All my children, my job at one time. I was homeless out here for 3 years. You know, not knowing where my next meal was coming from. You know, I was out here shoplifting to support my habit. It got bad. Many, many jail stays. You have to hit bottom. You have to, or you're just not going to get help. But it took me, you know, almost dying, not even being here, to do it.
Glad you're feeling better.
Yeah.
So I can see you.
Much better. Much better. So what do you like to do?
Well, I like to. Well, I really like, my favorite subject in school is science.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. It always caught my interest. God, I'm just telling you, I've never stopped thinking about you. Never, never. Mm-hmm. Even when I was out there messed up, man.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that would be my motivation to quit, to stop.
Mm-hmm.
But it wasn't enough.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm glad now that you are able to clean
Yeah, no desire.
As he went to bed that night, Kalib told his mom that was the best day of his life. A day of hope after heroin.